Hello, good afternoon. I'm Alfonso Jurado from La Paz University Hospital, Madrid. We are here in the first care of the day. Here beside me is Dr. Jimenez Valero and Patria, our nurse. And we have also the imaging unit with Silvia Balbuena, Jesús Aldaña. Carmen is also here. And outside is Borja, our fellow, and Clara. So Borja is going to present the case. Please, Borja.
Good morning, everyone. Today's first case is a 59-year-old male patient. As cardiovascular risk factor, he presents hypertension as dyslipidemia. His cardiology history revealed hypertrophic cardiomyopathy with a septal thickness of 29 millimeters in cardiac resonance. In the past, a defibrillator was implanted in primary prevention. Laboratory tests are normal. The electrocardiogram is in sinus rhythm with ventricular rhythm, stimulated with LVVV image. The usual treatment is bisoprolol, enalapril, heartians, and cantorbastatin. Currently, the patient is in functional class 2 despite medical treatment. In transthoracic echocardiogram, we can see severe hypertrophy. Gradients of flow track are 45 millimeters at baseline and 94 with Valsalva, despite optimizing the pacemaker AB interval. An angiography has been performed, no coronary lesions are seen, and septal of good caliber are observed. Today's plan is to perform an alcohol septal ablation, and the procedure will be guided by echocardiography.
Thank you, Borja. The current setup is that we have, as you can see, the patient has already permanent pacemaker, so we don't have to do it now. And we have a radial access with a pigtail in the left ventricle and 7 French EVU guiding catheter from the femoral right artery. This is the setup, and now Silvia can tell you some things about the imaging.
Hi, good morning, everyone. I'm the sonographer, and the guidance of the procedure, we're going to perform it with transthoracic echo. The patient is awake with us. Okay, so here you can see a 4-chamber view where we can see the total hypertrophy. The patient has a concentric global hypertrophy, but the thickest point is the septum, the basal and mid septum. So, and this happens to be also the area that creates the dynamic obstruction of the LVOT. So you can see here, I think you can see my echo, that here is the acceleration. The acoustic window is not great, but I think it's enough to guide the procedure. The gradient is in stimulated beats at least almost four meters, so it's a severe obstruction. Okay, you can also see here that there is anterior systolic movement, and it doesn't look like it's severe, but you can see here the anterior movement of the anterior mitral leaflet. Colleagues are going to do now is inject in the septal artery, so pay attention to the septum and the consistency of it, because we're going to inject and we're going to see where this saline flash or contrast is going to go, because that's the area we're going to infarct when we inject the alcohol solution. We also have the parasternal view, which is of better quality as a backup.
Thank you, Silvia. It's a very important thing that as said, that we have to store all the images, because after injecting gelafundin or even alcohol, we have to differentiate the white from the black areas, just to know the effect we are doing. As the patient has a pacemaker, you see that he has some own beats, and when the PR is optimized with the pacemaker, the gradient is lower. So you can see that the gradient probably is more or less 50 when it's paced, and more than 100 when he has his own. We can show you the septals we have seen. We can see here that the patient has probably 4 septals, and the 2 first ones are quite tiny, and we are in the 3rd one. We have access to this branch with a cyan blue wire, and we have an over-the-wire balloon 1.5 by 12. We're injecting a dead zone contrast, just to know we are not occluding the LAD, and I'm going to inflate to nominal pressures the balloon. Sometimes, just with the inflation, you can see the gradient is going down, so we are going to inject through the guiding catheter a little bit just to see that the septal is occluded and the LAD is not. We are retrieving now the wire. The balloon is still inflated all the time. And we are going to see if the septal is okay with some markers. We are using gelafunin, a cold. You can see the hands of Patrick working with the gelafunin. So we are injecting Sylvia now gelafunin, and you can see the echo in the screen. Probably it's difficult because it's a very big septum.
You can see that the consistency of the stent septum is changing.
So we need to differentiate with the gelafunin. The area we aim to ablate is the proper one.
The consistency of the septum has definitely changed. It makes a kind of acoustic noise. The mid septum,
and
downwards.
The endocardial part of the left ventricle is also more opacity, but the mid part seems to look contrast. Probably the next septal branch.
So we're going to inject a little bit more with a small syringe just to confirm this is the site. This is a very important key point of the procedure, because if you inject alcohol without this echo guidance, and you can have terrible complications. Some colleagues do this marking with Sonoview or other echo contrasts, but the problem is that this kind of contrast retaining inside the ventricle more time than the gelafunin, and the echo is always white. And if you fail choosing septal, so now the next step is with contrast, with pure contrast, we are going to inject through the balloon just to check if there is any collateral from this septal to another part of the heart.
PD.
Yeah.
There are some cases of inferior myocardial infarction during ablation. Probably this is the mechanism.
I don't see any collaterals. And the thing is how much alcohol is be administered. And probably,
according to the thickness of basal septum, 25 milliliters of alcohol is a rational approach.
When the patient has no permanent pacemaker, you have to insert a temporary pacemaker just in case you see some transient blocks with the injection of alcohol. We were waiting for the effect of fentanyl. Look at the ECG and the increasing gradient without pacing. Very slowly the alcohol. The balloon is inflated all the time. So we are injecting 1 cc and then check that everything is okay.
Brightness here, mainly in the subendocardial layer.
The patient is suffering a little pain. We are waiting a little bit. We have injected 1 cc now. And the most important thing is to have the balloon inflated. And then when you finish the administration of alcohol, you have to maintain also 10 minutes at least inflated the balloon after the last injection of alcohol.
We need at least another cc.
Yeah, the septum is thick, and it's also not a localized thickness, but it's almost all of the septum is quite thick.
Now probably is 20, no? A gradient more or less. And we started in 50, and now the pacemaker is working all the time. Probably it's an effect of the alcohol. You can see there is no proper beats. 1.5 injected of alcohol. You can see this is a very slow injection. Very slow. We have to be patient.
Maybe we can inject here another cc, but I think it will be necessary to explore the next septal.
I don't see big changes. Maybe the gradient has come down a bit, but in a non-stimulated beats, still sky high.
So we have here the countdown. So from now, 10 minutes with the balloon inflated, and then we come to the next septal. During the procedure, if you succeed, you see how the gradients go down. After that, during the admission, the inflammation goes up and the gradient comes again to the original one. And probably 6 months later or so, the fibrosis is performed, and if you are successful, the gradient is definitely low.
Yeah, that's important, because sometimes you expect an immediate effect, but you have to wait for the remodeling.
Any question from the audience?
Yes, we have one question. Are there any specific consideration for navigating the catheter in the septal branch?
No, not especially. No. Coaxial balloon 1.5, and the navigation is not usually complex circumstances. Sometimes it's difficult to cannulate to selective wire the septal, but usually performing a more prominent J curve, it's relatively easy to enter the septal and then coaxial balloon.
We are struggling for 20 minutes to engage the correct septal, but after you have the septal, the balloon goes almost always, because they are usually normal coronary arteries. And the other thing of the balloon is that you have to choose a balloon 1-to-1 to the size of the septal just to occlude it properly. So in this case, we have chosen a 1.5.
Another practical issue is that we use a coaxial balloon, so we need a longer wire, or even perform like we do previously a trapping of the wire to advance the coaxial balloon.
Yeah, it's quite, for me, it's more uncomfortable to work with a 300 wire in length, because it's quite uncomfortable. So having the experience of the CTOs and complex and rote ablator and all these things, we prefer to do trapping. But you need a specific device or seven friends. This is true. Any okay. other questions?
Yeah. Any consideration for the administration of the alcohol?
No, as Alfonso said, in the case, very slow injection, monitoring of the ECG to see some type of conduction abnormalities. But this patient is already on pacemaker rhythm, so we don't have this problem. The anticipated amount of contrast of alcohol, the rule that Alfonso said about 1 cc per 10 millimeters of septal thickness.
For the echo team, are there any specific criteria you use during the echocardiography guide procedure to ensure optical outcomes?
Well, I think in this procedure, the main objective of echocardiographic guidance is to ensure safety. So the main thing is not to inject alcohol in a septal that irrigates the structure that we don't want to infarct, for example, a papillary muscle or part of the right ventricle. So that's the main point. Sometimes the effectiveness of the procedure, depending on the septal anatomy, you can inject if you think it's safe to do it, and well, expect the best result. The main point of the guidance, of the echo guidance, is to ensure safe in this scenario.
To wait just 3 more minutes. A very interesting point, we are seeing the ECG, and now you can see some, there are not proper beats, but sometimes they are stimulated only in the ventricle, and other times in the atria and in the ventricles. So we are doing something there with the alcohol that is changing the stimulation and also the gradient. So we are going to retrieve, after the 3 more minutes, we are going to retrieve aspirating the balloon, just in case there is some alcohol inside the catheter, and then let the guiding catheter breathe, and again, advance with the wire to the next septal. And another important thing is to mark the syringe with the alcohol and differentiate perfectly syringes. And when do you, Santi, consider procedure successful?
The perfect result, zero gradient, but our objective should be at least 50% reduction of basal gradient. When you find the accurate septal branch, the effect is very marked and you see drastic reduction in the gradient.
This patient that has 3 or 4 big septals, we can see also compression of the septal in the myocardium. Probably we need to treat more than one. In patients with only 1 big septal, the effect is like
in the second of the big tal branches, that the bigger of the branches have a clear phenomenon of milking or systolic compression due to be inside the hypertrophic myocardium. So probably this tal will be more accurate than the previous one.
Yeah, the thing is also you can see here in the echo that the extension of the area of obstruction is very long. Like from the mid-ventricular area to the basal segments. So it's a big area in terms of longitudinal extension.
No, it's a challenging case because it's a very big septum. The gradient, as Silvia said, is not in a certain point. So yeah, it's a case for mainstream.
Well, we have wait 10 minutes after the last injection of alcohol. So we deflate.
We fill the balloon and we are aspirating. We are negative pressures.
Retrieve the balloon because we will use another time this balloon and to lose the alcohol remaining in the
LAD. Back bleeding here, and you are sure everything. So let's go with the wire again. This one, I don't know if it's a little bit more difficult to engage because it's like bifurcated from the area. And I think we have to go to the first one. So we are doing the trapping balloon technique, advancing at 2.5. Balloon in a 7 French guiding catheter, up to 18, more or less. Check that the wire is trapped. And let's go with the balloon. You can also advance together the balloon and the wire, but now as we have the trapping balloon here, and Patty was washing the balloon very well.
You can see the 1.5 balloon entering the septal. If we inflate back proximal, we can occlude the branches. The problem is that if we are very near the LAD, when we retrieve the wire, the valve can go up. Mm-hmm. So I think we are going to inflate here.
A second, another test, please, just to... Yeah. I think we are there, okay. I'm going to store this. I'm going to inflate the balloon.
To see if we are occluding the two branches.
The second is open, but LED is okay, and this branch is with
more, more selective injection in the target branch.
And the other thing is, look, the first septal we treated. Okay, we're retrieving the wire. We are repeating the same steps with the gelafundin. Probably the white part you can see in the echo is the alcohol, because the gelafundin is washing. We're injecting. The amount of gelafundin you need is similar than the alcohol, probably with 1 cc or so. Yeah,
it seems it goes to the mid ventricular.
Yeah,
okay. And it's not going anywhere, no? Anywhere else, I mean.
No, nowhere else. The papillary muscles are fine, the apex is fine.
Free wall.
I don't really see the right ventricular free wall. But
the septum looks a good place.
Yeah.
Agree?
It's a bit more apical than previous injection.
Administer contrast through the balloon. Inflated balloon to check there is no collateral to other parts with the angio. No collaterals. Okay. If you do this step before the gelafundin, probably you opacified everything in the echo and you can't see anything. Okay. We are injecting very slowly. Once you see more of alcohol here in this branch, and remember, just start your chronometer at the last injection. We're administering fentanyl before every injection of alcohol. This is not the usual case of alcohol septal ablation. We usually inject less alcohol than now, but this case is quite special because of the thickness of the septum.
Look, you can see here how the mid-septum has become hypokinetic.
And the other consideration in this patient is that if surgery is a better option than alcohol septal ablation or pacing, no? Surgery implies higher risk in a young patient as well. This procedure is not successful. You have this option as well. We're injecting 0.5 more and probably stop. And then we start with chronometer, 10 minutes more.
The balloon is in place.
The most difficult procedure we do here, but you have to be very precise with patients step by step because you have a complication. Now let's see the other projections if we have another septal. Some groups are doing only one septal per procedure and let the patient came back again just to be sure to not have any complication. Right. But as I told you, this is a special one because of the thickness of the septum. What do you think? While we wait?
I think that unfortunately radiant response is not expected. It's only 10, 15.
Any contraindication for a cold septal ablation?
The main probably is the anatomy is not appropriate for this case. Ideal case with very proximal big septal branch, the one.
Only one.
But in this case, you can see there are at least 4 branches that would be treatable. With the septal thickness is not below 50 millimeters, is relative contraindication to inject.
Very, very small septums below 15, that also the diagnosis of hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is controversial,
yep.
And even larger than 30, and we have 20 something in this case,
yep.
Relative contraindications. And the main thing is the anatomy of the septus, I think. And to check everyone with the gelafundin or some of you or whatever, just to check you are not doing any complication. You can not succeed, but you have no complications, and that's all.
We have time to test the first septal. It's the smaller, but I think that sometimes it's not a matter of amount of contrast. The main factor is the place, accurate position to ablate. The more basal, the more superficial endocardium near the contact, the systolic anterior movement of the anterior mitral leaflet.
And you mean the first one or the first we treated?
No, the first thing that we enter.
Curve one, a very tiny, but the second
is
one.
It's very complex because it's too proximal and very angulated, but I think that the entry in the second septal is here, and I think that
this one
would be at least 1 cc. We can test
if we do that. I think we will have time. The problem is this balloon, probably the guide wire is going to be stuck because we have had some problems in retrieving the wire.
And we can use another balloon.
Use another balloon. And this branch is smaller, so yeah. Probably we can use the 1.2 balloon.
Yeah, in the echo, you can see that we have almost reached the apical septum almost. So I would definitely not go any farther to the fourth septal.
For sure. This is a special case. We usually focus on the very basal septum, but now in this mid-ventricular gradient, very big septum, we have changed the usual.
This is the problem. You cannot choose the anatomy. Yeah. It's a uncontrolled factor.
Yeah. And sometimes coronary angiography at the same procedure, but for this case, we have done a coronary angio before just to check the patient has some septals to ablate.
Okay, let's deflate.
We are doing negative pressure and Sandy is retrieving the balloon and we can throw out this balloon.
The two septals that we have treated are occluded.
We can go with the balloon and the wire inside the balloon at the same time. We avoid the trapping. So probably if you're doing this procedure in your labs, it's not a good idea to do 3 or 4 septals in the first day. Okay, you're almost there. I'm going to check a bit. So the same steps. We're going to inflate. Nominal pressure is the same, 8. I'm going to inject through the guiding. Septal is occluded, the LED is okay. We retrieve the wire. And then we will repeat the thing with the laughing in.
I don't know if I'm going to see anything this time.
Yeah.
Because I have the shadow, the acoustic
yeah,
shadow.
Yeah, the alcohol.
Top ablated myocardium.
Let's see the gradient.
The main thing is not to see any white thing outside the, in the apex
outside.
Or we're injecting, Silvia.
Okay.
What do you think?
I don't see anything wrong, I mean.